Welcome back to Seat the Seekers. I'm Tejal Patel, and this is the place to be if you're looking to spread love, live consciously, and create peace and happiness in your life. And today's vlog is on relationships, and what more fitting for February, the month of thinking about love, and with Valentine's Day just passing by, love and relationships are already on our mind. So it's just a fitting topic, and we're going to be talking about how we can grow with our significant other, even though we're on different spiritual paths and different places in our spirituality. And one of the things when we are embracing this spiritual journey is that relationships are two complete individuals who come in union to express their higher love and to evolve and grow to a higher consciousness. And yes, that is our goal. But let's be real. Not all of us are on our spiritual journey when we enter into a relationship. So, of course, when you do embark on it and you're in a relationship, everybody is on in a different space. And so you might be growing at a different space than your significant other. And I feel that Jerry Maguire had all wrong. You don't complete me, I complete myself. So once we start the healing, once we start to do the inner work, yes, we will reach that place where we are complete and whole individuals, but we have to recognize that all relationships are brought into our awareness because of the vibrational match that we are. So if we're at a lower frequency at the time that we meet, it's because we have the same type of life lessons that we need to learn from each other. And we have to honor each relationship and recognize that all relationships that fade away, it's meant to because they serve their higher purpose. And those that come into our lives are there for a specific reason. So the first tip that I can have for you guys is that remember that your relationship is a lesson, and all those challenges and those triggers and those annoying things that your significant other does that gets under your skin is absolutely necessary for you to understand how you can heal. What are the areas in your life that you need to work on? Anger, communication, jealousy, insecurity, frustration, whatever it is that shows up, the feelings that arise when there's uncomfortability in your relationship, be blessed, because those are your opportunities and doors opening for you to really change and grow. So don't feel that, oh, this relationship is not working and he's not doing what I say, or, you know, we're not vibing. Well, he's brought or she's brought into your life for a reason. So recognize and try to learn from the mistakes, because until you learn the lesson, the same pattern and the same lesson is going to keep repeating in your relationships. It doesn't matter who the person is that if your lesson is not completed, then it's going to keep showing up in different ways. So honor the challenges and the things that trigger us to feel uncomfortability. The second thing is honoring that each individual is going on their separate journey at a different pace, at a different time, in a different path. So even if you're on a relationship and you have started to find your way, recognize and honor that, you know what, that might not serve your boyfriend, girlfriend, husband, wife. It might not serve them. So be honest and allow them to have their journey. Honor your journey and follow the path that resonates with you, but don't get discouraged if that's not their path. The next thing is recognizing that when you embark on the spiritual journey, you are going to need spiritual connections, because you're going to have questions and you're going to have this urge to learn and teach and inspire and share. And a lot of times when you're not getting that feedback and that reinforcement from your significant other, you feel depleted. You feel like you don't have that communication And there are different ways that you can communicate to other people. Find like-minded individuals so that you can have normal conversations with your significant other that you don't feel like you need to be talking about spirituality. So there's sources like herfuture.com, which is a digital sisterhood where you can share inspiring information. Go to different blogs, reach out to them. You know, go to inspirational seminars like Chris Carr, you know, Gabby Bernstein. There's different networks that you can be a part of that will help you be in contact with spiritually minded people that resonate with you. And the next thing is be the example. It is so easy when you find all this lofty information to share it and want to give so much wisdom to the people that you love, but recognize that not everybody is ready and are in the space that you're in to absorb and understand it. So allow yourself just to be the example by people understanding and how you're being different. If they feel your energy being different, if they see how you react differently to situations, they're going to be inspired by your actions, and you won't even have to feel like you're preaching or teaching or lecturing them or trying to force them to change when they're not ready to. They will come to you when they see a change within you, and that's the best way of really connecting to people when it's on their terms and they feel comfortable coming to you for help. So remember, this journey is your own individual journey, but you're also growing in your relationship. You have lessons that you are meant to learn together. So honor your individual journey, honor your significant other's individual journey, and know that you guys are helping each other grow and evolve into a better couple and better human beings. So I hope that served you well, and like always, if you found this inspiring, share with your family and friends, and certainly subscribe to Estate the Seekers if this really resonated with you. So until next week, my friends, namaste, bye-bye.